Want to speed up your language learning? Get access to all of our best PDF cheat sheets for free. Just click the link in the description and sign up for your free lifetime account right now.
Some of the most important Dutch verbs. Let's get started. Zijn. Zijn. To be. Hij is piloot. Hij is piloot. He is a pilot. Now, like many languages, Dutch has strong and weak verbs, and zijn is a typical strong verb. And that's why zijn doesn't look or sound anything like is, hij is piloot. So, in combination with hij or zij, he or she, the verb zijn sounds like is. Leuk vinden. Leuk vinden. To like. Ik vind haar leuk. Ik vind haar leuk. I like her. Now, if you're saying this in Dutch, especially about a person, then it usually means that you have a little crush on them. So be careful when you use this. Doen. Doen. To do. Wij doen de afwas. Wij doen de afwas. We are doing the dishes. This is also a strong verb, but it's recognizable here. The word doen or do can be used for many different things, and there's a lot of different meanings to it, just like in English. Zeggen. Zeggen. To say. Zij zegt helemaal niets. Zij zegt helemaal niets. She says nothing at all. This is just a very neutral word. If you're going to ask someone to tell you a story, then you can start the sentence with zeg. For example, you can say, zeg, hoe is het afgelopen met John? I say, whatever happened to John? Except it's less archaic in Dutch than it is in English. Horen. Horen. To hear. Ik hoor de trein. Ik hoor de trein. I hear the train. There's an easy way to remember this one, because the verb horen sounds a lot like oren. So, horen doe je met je oren. You hear with your ears. Gaan. Gaan. To go. Zij gaan naar huis. Zij gaan naar huis. They are going home. Gaan can also mean leaving. For example, if you say ik ga, that means I'm leaving. Weten. Weten. To know. Ik weet niets. Ik weet niets. I know nothing. Jon Snow. That's literally the only time I've ever seen that sentence. So in Dutch, unless you're quoting Game of Thrones, you would say, ik weet het niet. I don't know. Nemen. Nemen. To take. Kun je de fiets nemen? Kun je de fiets nemen? Could you take the bike? So this is nemen in the context of choosing a means of transportation. So, ik neem een appel means I'll take an apple. You can also say, ik neem de telefoon op. Opnemen means answering a phone. And you can say, ik neem een boek mee. Meenemen means to take something with you. So, the verb nemen, you can combine it with many prepositions. Zien. Zien. To see. Hij ziet heel weinig. Hij ziet heel weinig. He doesn't see much. So, zien is spelled with a Z, but the Dutch aren't that particular about it, so it just sounds very slightly different from an S. So with an S you would say zien, and with a Z you would say zien. Do you hear it? Zien. Zien. It's a small difference, but it's there. Komen. Komen. To come. Ze komen morgen op visite. Ze komen morgen op visite. They will come and visit us tomorrow. Another example would be if someone calls you and you want to say, I'm coming. You would say, ik kom eraan. Denken. Denken. To think. Ik denk aan lekker eten. Ik denk aan lekker eten. I am thinking of delicious food. Hear, hear. So unlike in some other languages, denken is very versatile. So you can say, ik denk aan je, I'm thinking of you. Or, ik denk dat het de blauwe is, I believe it's the blue one. So you can use it for both the active act of thinking and for when you mean you believe something to be true. Kijken. Kijken. To look. Ik kijk naar het huis. Ik kijk naar het huis. I'm looking at the house. This is a tricky sound if you don't speak Dutch. Ei. That's because it's a diphthong, which means it's actually consisting of two vowels, like every set of vowels in the phrase, no highway cowboys. So, no highway cowboys. Was that clear or was it just a weird sentence pronounced really slowly? I can't tell. Willen. Willen. To want. Zij wil een hond. Zij wil een hond. She wants a dog. Now, don't be fooled by those silly Dutch people who say wilt. Zij wilt. That's not correct. And wilt is often not the correct word. So if you want to be completely safe, just never use wilt, always say wil. Ik wil, jij wil, hij wil. That's it. You can't go wrong with that. Geven. Geven. To give. Ik geef mijn vriend een verjaardagscadeau. Ik geef mijn vriend een verjaardagscadeau. I'm giving my friend a birthday present. You can also give other things, like when you say, pas op, of ik geef je een schop. You're saying, watch out, or I'll give you a kick. Gebruiken. Gebruiken. To use. Hij gebruikt de auto. Hij gebruikt de auto. He is using the car. This is another typical example of a diphthong. It's a tricky sound to make. Ui. Ui. Gebruiken. Keep practicing. Vinden. Vinden. To find. Ik kan mijn haarborstel niet vinden. Ik kan mijn haarborstel niet vinden. I can't find my hairbrush. This is a daily struggle for people like me. Usually when I'm saying this, I'm already holding it in my hand and I've forgotten that I found it. Uitgaan. Uitgaan. To go out. Morgen gaan we uit. Morgen gaan we uit. We will go out tomorrow. Now this is a tricky one because uitgaan can mean to go out for drinks, like here, but it can also mean to step out of bed. For example, when you say, ik ga eruit, you mean I'm getting up. Vragen. Vragen. To ask. Vraag het aan je moeder. Vraag het aan je moeder. Ask your mother. This is what you do every time you have new clothes and you need to know how they can be laundered. Werken. Werken. To work. Zij werkt bij de bank. Zij werkt bij de bank. She works at the bank. This one sounds a lot like the English one, and it's almost written exactly the same way too. Work, werk, but then with an E instead of an O. Binnengaan. Binnengaan. To enter. Het restaurant binnengaan. Het restaurant binnengaan. To enter the restaurant. You may also say binnenlopen, which means the same thing, but it has the meaning of walking in there. Or binnenkomen, if it's from the perspective of someone who is already inside. So if you're sitting inside and someone comes in, you would say, hij komt binnen, rather than hij gaat naar binnen. Voelen. Voelen. To feel. Ik voel het in mijn tenen. Ik voel het in mijn tenen. I feel it in my toes. So it's also not very difficult to see the connection here. Feel, voel. Okay, so to be fair, it only has three sounds and two of them have changed, but you see what I mean, right? Proberen. Proberen. To try. We proberen het gewoon nog eens. We proberen het gewoon nog eens. We will just try it again. So this is a tough one, because proberen sounds absolutely nothing like try. They say it comes from the Latin word probare, which means tasting. So maybe that helps you. Verlaten. Verlaten. To leave. Hij verlaat het feest. Hij verlaat het feest. He is leaving the party. Now, you may want to be careful with this one because verlaten is a very loaded word. So it means something like to leave alone. You can also say that you feel verlaten. Ik voel me verlaten. And that means that you're feeling abandoned and lonely. So be careful how you use this. Bellen. Bellen. To call. Kun je mij bellen? Kun je mij bellen? Can you call me? There's an interesting background to this one. The word bellen comes from the name Alexander Graham Bell, who was the inventor of the telephone. Rennen. Rennen. To run. Het kind rent naar huis. Het kind rent naar huis. The child runs home. Here again, the words are quite alike, so you would be likely to recognize it without too much trouble. The noun ren also refers to an enclosed piece of land for chickens or rabbits. So the more you know. The first one. Hoe heet u? Hoe heet u? What's your name? An answer to this could be, ik heet Jacob. Ik heet Jacob. My name is Jacob. So this is just your basic introduction, but an important thing to remember is that the Dutch word u is very formal. So if you want to ask a coworker or a classmate or someone who is the same age as you what their name is, you should probably say je instead of u. So it would be, hoe heet je? Hoe gaat het? Hoe gaat het? How are you? And an answer might be, met mij gaat het goed. Met mij gaat het goed. I am doing well. Now, this is a pretty long sentence that you don't necessarily need to, you know, say in full. If someone asks, hoe gaat het? You can just shorten it and say, goed. Waar kom je vandaan? Waar kom je vandaan? Where are you from? Sample answer, ik kom uit Amsterdam. Ik kom uit Amsterdam. I am from Amsterdam. Now, if you're just asking this question flat out, then people might consider that to be a little direct. So a more gentle way of asking this is just assuming that someone is from somewhere and then letting them correct you. So you could ask, kom je uit Amsterdam? Which means, are you from Amsterdam? And then someone else could say, no, actually, I'm from Haarlem. Hoe oud ben je? Hoe oud ben je? How old are you? Possible answer. Ik ben 20 jaar. Ik ben 20 jaar. I am 20 years old. So if you're answering this question, you may actually leave out jaar. You can just say, ik ben 20. And leave it at that. That's more common. Waar werk je? Waar werk je? Where do you work? Ik werk in Rotterdam. Ik werk in Rotterdam. I work in Rotterdam. Though this sample answer is city, you're more likely to get an answer with something like I work in marketing or I work at Coolblue or whatever.
So when you're asking someone where they work, it's assumed that you're talking about the job, not the actual location. Here's an opportunity to learn some numbers. Wat is je telefoonnummer? Wat is je telefoonnummer? What is your phone number? Answer. Mijn telefoonnummer is 012-345-6678. Mijn telefoonnummer is 012-345-6678. My phone number is 012-345-6678. So now you also have an idea of all the numbers from 0 to 8. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hou je van Nederlands eten? Hou je van Nederlands eten? Do you like Dutch food? A likely answer to this is nee. Ik hou niet van Nederlands eten. Nee, ik hou niet van Nederlands eten. No, I don't like Dutch food. So some typical Dutch dishes are hutspot, which is mashed potatoes with mashed carrots. And beschuit met muisjes, which is like a crispy biscuit with small pink or blue and white little balls on it. And they're made of sugar and aniseed. And that's traditionally eaten at the birth of a child. Well, to celebrate the birth of a child. Heb je broers of zussen? Heb je broers of zussen? Do you have any brothers or sisters? And an answer to this may be, ja, ik heb een broer. Ja, ik heb een broer. Yes, I have one brother. So there's no real Dutch equivalent to the word siblings, so you'll always have to ask if they have brothers or sisters. It can be a little bit of a pain, but there's just no alternative, so sorry. Ben je wel eens in Nederland geweest? Ben je wel eens in Nederland geweest? Have you ever been to the Netherlands? A likely answer. Nee, ik ben er nog niet geweest. Nee, ik ben er nog niet geweest. No, I haven't been there yet. Waar heb je Nederlands geleerd? Waar heb je Nederlands geleerd? Where did you learn Dutch? Sample answer would be, ik heb het op school geleerd. Ik heb het op school geleerd. I have learned it at school. I don't actually know if there is any country except for the Netherlands where they teach Dutch. We're not very popular in that sense.
Ik mis je. I miss you. This next one is rather sad. Ik mis je. Ik mis je. I miss you. As you can hear, the Dutch and English version of this are very similar, so it's easy to remember. You usually say this when you're on the phone with someone, in other words, when they're not actually there with you. Or you say it about someone else. You could say, for example, ik mis mama. I miss mom. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. You did a great job. This is a nice one if you want to tell someone they did well. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. You did a great job. You can also shorten it to goed gedaan or goed zo, meaning good job. It's a little more casual that way. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. There will be a bonus at the end of the month. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. There's a bonus at the end of the month. So nice to hear. Sadly, it doesn't happen as often as we'd like. Je kunt erg goed koken. You're an excellent cook. So imagine you've gone to dinner at a friend's place and the food was great. You could say, je kunt erg goed koken. Je kunt erg goed koken. You're an excellent cook. So if the food wasn't really good, but you still want to be polite, but you also don't really want that person to ever touch a pan or a stove again, you can say, dankjewel voor het koken. Thank you for cooking. This is still very nice, but you don't have to actually say that dinner was amazing. Dank je, maar eigenlijk ben ik geen native speaker. Thank you, but I'm not a native speaker, actually. After this class, people automatically assume that you're a native speaker, and then you can baffle them with this sentence. Dank je, maar eigenlijk ben ik geen native speaker. Dank je, maar eigenlijk ben ik geen native speaker. Thank you, but I'm actually not a native speaker. So make sure this comes out completely fluent, because you don't want to ruin the effect. So did you notice that the Dutch verb for native speaker is just native speaker borrowed from the English? That ought to make it a little bit easier for you.
Ik had maar een jaar nodig om er fluent in te worden. It only took me 1 year to become fluent.
Next sentence. Ik had maar een jaar nodig om er fluent in te worden. Ik had maar een jaar nodig om er fluent in te worden. And this means it only took me 1 year to become fluent. Now don't feel bad if this is not true. Dutch is a notoriously difficult language to master, so it will probably take anyone more than a year.
Ik ben al 10 jaar Nederlands aan het leren. I've been learning Dutch for 10 years.
This next one is for everyone who feels that it's going to take some more time. Ik ben al 10 jaar Nederlands aan het leren. Ik ben al 10 jaar Nederlands aan het leren. I've been learning Dutch for 10 years. So to be honest, even native Dutch speakers make mistakes. I've been learning Dutch for 27 years. It's a hard language, guys, so don't feel bad.
Ik kan Nederlandse films zonder ondertiteling kijken. I can watch Dutch movies without subtitles.
Here's one that's a true accomplishment, and it's within reach. Ik kan Nederlandse films zonder ondertiteling kijken. Ik kan Nederlandse films zonder ondertiteling kijken. And this means I can watch Dutch movies without subtitles. Now the only question remaining is, why would you want to watch Dutch movies? I'm just kidding. There's one movie that I really do like and can recommend, and it's called Minus. The story is by Annie M. G. Schmid, and it has Carice van Houten in it. So it's a really great movie. It's about a woman who's actually a cat, I think.
Boek. Book. Mijn vader leest graag boeken. Mijn vader leest graag boeken. My father likes to read books. I also love books, but to be honest, I don't think they make for very good gifts unless I've specifically requested to have that book. Otherwise, it just feels like a chore. Parfum. Perfume. Heb je het nieuwe parfum al? Heb je het nieuwe parfum al? Do you already have that new perfume? Another really easy one. Do you guys wear perfume? I have one that smells like fresh laundry, and I use that a lot. It's the best scent ever. Een vlucht naar Nederland. A flight to the Netherlands. Volgende week ga ik een vlucht naar Nederland boeken. Volgende week ga ik een vlucht naar Nederland boeken. Next week I'm going to book a flight to the Netherlands. Now I see why this dictionary might come in handy. Uh-huh. Practice the pronunciation on this one. That g sound is pretty hard. Vlucht.
Op reis gaan naar het buitenland. Op reis gaan naar het buitenland. To travel abroad. Now this first one, I must admit, is pretty ironic, because a lovely thing to do in the summer in the Netherlands is op reis gaan naar het buitenland. Op reis gaan naar het buitenland. To travel abroad. Het is leuk om op reis te gaan naar het buitenland. Het is leuk om op reis te gaan naar het buitenland. It's fun to travel abroad. It's very realistic though. The number one activity in the Netherlands in summer is leave the Netherlands. It's always raining here. Relaxen op het strand. Relaxen op het strand. To relax at the beach. Relaxen op het strand. Relaxen op het strand. Relax at the beach. Ga je morgen mee relaxen op het strand? Ga je morgen mee relaxen op het strand? Are you coming with us tomorrow to relax on the beach? Now be warned, the Dutch beaches aren't exceptionally beautiful and the water is cold as hell, but it's a lovely day out and other than that it's great. So here comes another very useful thing to do in summer. Nederlands leren met DutchPod101.com. Nederlands leren met DutchPod101.com. To learn Dutch with DutchPod101.com. Nederlands leren met DutchPod101.com. Nederlands leren met DutchPod101.com. To learn Dutch with DutchPod101.com. Nederlands leren met DutchPod101.com is een leuke hobby. Nederlands leren met DutchPod101.com is een leuke hobby. Learning Dutch with DutchPod101.com is a fun hobby. See how we snuck a little self-promotion in there? I bet you didn't even notice it, did you? Leren om Nederlands eten te koken. Leren om Nederlands eten te koken. To learn to cook Dutch food. Leren om Nederlands eten te koken. Leren om Nederlands eten te koken. To learn to cook Dutch food. Zullen we leren om Nederlands eten te koken? Zullen we leren om Nederlands eten te koken? Shall we learn how to cook Dutch food? Small tip, don't pick hutspot or andijvie. Those things are really gross. Pick a breakfast dish. The Dutch breakfast dishes are usually fine.
Want to speak real Dutch from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at DutchPod101.com.
Let's start with, je ziet er geweldig uit vandaag. Je ziet er geweldig uit vandaag. You look great today. Always nice to hear, right? Don't use it too often, you don't want it to lose its meaning.
This is still not exactly nice, but this isn't terrible either. I guess it depends on how you say it. This next one is as annoying as it is satisfying.
This one is a touch more realistic. Ik spreek in 3 jaar tijd Nederlands als een native speaker. Ik spreek in 3 jaar tijd Nederlands als een native speaker. So this sentence is said like it's like a New Year's resolution, right? So if you want to say that it has already happened, then you should use the past tense. So you would say, ik sprak in 3 jaar tijd, instead of ik spreek.
Mijn broer eet veel diepvriesmaaltijden. Mijn broer eet veel diepvriesmaaltijden. My brother eats a lot of frozen meals. Yeah, that would be unhealthy. Especially if he still eats them while they're frozen. So that's no wonder he's going to die young. Sorry.
Wij bewaren veel oude kranten. Wij bewaren veel oude kranten. We conserve a lot of old newspapers. Now, what you eventually do with those newspapers is probably more important than the fact you're just stacking them up in your basement. Personally, I use my old newspapers to line my birdcage with.
Gisteren heb ik de hele nacht gefeest. Gisteren heb ik de hele nacht gefeest.
I partied all night yesterday. Now, to be honest, I don't really know what that's like, because I'm not much of a party animal myself, so I can't give you any insights on what great party places are in the Netherlands, but probably Amsterdam.
Mijn zus heeft een blauw badpak.
Mijn zus heeft een blauw badpak.
My sister has a blue swimsuit.
It's probably important to tell you that the word badpak only means like a one-piece swimsuit, so it's not a bikini. A bikini is not a badpak. Where I guess it would be a swimsuit. So there's a distinction there. I wish I could come up with some positive association for you guys, like making new friends or whatever, but to be honest, I'm just really glad I don't have to go through that anymore. Growing up is awesome, guys.
In oktober zie je al vallende bladeren. In oktober zie je al vallende bladeren.
You can already see falling leaves in October.
Be careful. In Dutch, we do not spell the words of months with a capital letter at the beginning.
Heb jij ook een fiets? Heb jij ook een fiets?
Do you also have a bicycle?
In the Netherlands, everyone has a bicycle. It's not even a valid question, really, if someone has one. You do. I think I know literally one person who doesn't have a bike, and that's because it just got stolen. So the roads here are very bicycle-friendly, and it's a great way to get around.
Dank je. Dank je. Thank you. And again, if you're in a formal situation, say, dank u,
De auto staat tussen de andere auto's. De auto staat tussen de andere auto's. The car is among the other cars. Tussen also means between. For example, if you got your finger stuck in the door, you can say, mijn vinger zat tussen de deur. That means that it was stuck between the door and the post, and it really hurt.
Ja. Ja. Yes.
Boeing maakt vliegtuigen. Boeing maakt vliegtuigen. Boeing makes airplanes. If you were to translate vliegtuig literally, I guess it would mean something like fly tool, so it's pretty accurate.
Okay, okay. And of course it means okay. It's the same word and you can basically spell it any way you like, so go to town.
Ik kan mijn haarborstel niet vinden. Ik kan mijn haarborstel niet vinden. I can't find my hairbrush. This is a daily struggle for people like me. Usually when I'm saying this, I'm already holding it in my hand and I've forgotten that I found it.
Het spijt me. Het spijt me. I'm sorry. You can also say sorry if you've done a small thing wrong, but if you've really made a mess of things, you may want to go all the way and just go with het spijt me.
Vraag het aan je moeder. Vraag het aan je moeder. Ask your mother. This is what you do every time you have new clothes and you need to know how they can be laundered.
Waar is het toilet? Waar is het toilet? Where is the restroom? So I'm sure you recognize the word toilet in there, but if you want to sound very Dutch, use wc for water closet. So then you would say, waar is de wc?
Het restaurant binnengaan. Het restaurant binnengaan. To enter the restaurant. You may also say binnenlopen, which means the same thing, but it has the meaning of walking in there. Or binnenkomen, if it's from the perspective of someone who is already inside. So if you're sitting inside and someone comes in, you would say hij komt binnen, rather than hij gaat naar binnen.
Hoeveel kost dit? How much is this? Though usually when you're in the Netherlands, there will be clear price tags on everything. The Dutch don't haggle.
We proberen het gewoon nog eens. We proberen het gewoon nog eens. We will just try it again. So this is a tough one, because proberen sounds absolutely nothing like try. They say it comes from the Latin word probare, which means tasting. So maybe that helps you.
Help. Help. It just means help. Sometimes life will throw you a bone.
Kun je mij bellen? Kun je mij bellen? Can you call me? There's an interesting background to this one. The word bellen comes from the name Alexander Graham Bell, who was the inventor of the telephone.
Tot ziens. Tot ziens. Goodbye. You're technically saying the same thing you were earlier. It just means that you'll see each other again. But this is the one you would use in a grocery store, whereas you would say tot later or later to a friend.
Want to speed up your language learning? Get access to all of our best PDF cheat sheets for free. Just click the link in the description and sign up for your free lifetime account right now.
Thank you.
gift ideas. Let's get started. Boek. Boek. Mijn vader leest graag boeken. Mijn vader leest graag boeken.
My father likes to read books. I also love books, but to be honest, I don't think they make for very good gifts unless I've specifically requested to have that book. Otherwise, it just feels like a chore.
Parfum.
Parfum.
Heb je het nieuwe parfum al?
Heb je het nieuwe parfum al?
Do you already have that new perfume? Another really easy one. Do you guys wear perfume? I have one that smells like fresh laundry, and I use that a lot. It's the best scent ever.
Next one's also very easy, guys. You got this.
Camera.
Camera.
Een dure camera kopen.
Een dure camera kopen.
To buy an expensive camera.
This is another insanely expensive gift. It even says so. I mean, here's an idea. If someone loves photography, get them a nice accessory, like a filter or an easy way to store their lens cap or something.
Whew.
Oh, this one isn't really better though. Smartphone.
Smartphone.
Zij heeft de nieuwste smartphone.
Zij heeft de nieuwste smartphone.
She has the newest smartphone. I definitely don't have the newest smartphone. I've had mine repaired like 3 times and it still works well. It's much better for the environment that way, though the battery does drain very quickly.
Spelcomputer.
Game console.
De PS3 is mijn favoriete spelcomputer.
De PS3 is mijn favoriete spelcomputer.
The PS3 is my favorite console.
What's your favorite console? I got a Game Boy Color when I was like 9 or something, I think. And I don't think I let it out of my hands for the first 5 years after that. Good times.
Woordenboek.
Dictionary.
Van Dalen is een Nederlands woordenboek.
Van Dalen is een Nederlands woordenboek.
Van Dalen is a Dutch dictionary.
Why would you give someone a dictionary as a gift? Like, happy birthday, here's some light reading. I don't know, unless you're really into the dictionary game, I don't really see how this would be a great gift. Unless you're learning Dutch and it's a Dutch dictionary, of course.
Next word. Een vlucht naar Nederland.
A flight to the Netherlands.
Volgende week ga ik een vlucht naar Nederland boeken.
Volgende week ga ik een vlucht naar Nederland boeken.
Next week, I'm going to book a flight to the Netherlands.
Now I see why this dictionary might come in handy.
Uh-huh. Practice the pronunciation on this one. That ch sound is pretty hard.
Vlucht.
Kleding.
Clothes.
Zij koopt elke maand nieuwe kleding.
Zij koopt elke maand nieuwe kleding.
Every month, she buys new clothes.
Instead of kleding, you can also say kleren, which also means clothes. And an interesting thing about the word kleren is that it's plurale tantum, which means the word doesn't exist in singular form.
Fles wijn.
Bottle of wine.
Een fles wijn graag.
Een fles wijn graag.
A bottle of wine, please.
Now here's a gift that most adults will appreciate. I mean, even if they don't drink wine themselves, you can always, you know, use it when guests come to visit or something.
Next word. Fiets.
Bicycle.
Heb jij ook een fiets?
Heb jij ook een fiets?
Do you also have a bicycle?
In the Netherlands, everyone has a bicycle. It's not even a valid question, really, if someone has one. You do. I think I know literally one person who doesn't have a bike, and that's because it just got stolen. So the roads here are very bicycle-friendly, and it's a great way to get around.
Foods that will kill you faster, as opposed to foods that will only kill you slowly, I guess.
Spek.
Spek.
Bacon.
So the first word of today is spek. Bacon.
Ik vind spek erg lekker.
Ik vind spek erg lekker. I like bacon very much.
Me too, my friend. Unfortunately, I'm a vegetarian, so it's just lettuce and sadness for me. Anyway, so bacon in Dutch is spek, but you can also just say bacon because actually many Dutch people just use the word bacon.
Energiedranken.
Energiedranken.
Energy drinks.
The second one, energiedranken. Energy drinks.
Energiedranken zijn erg zoet.
Energiedranken zijn erg zoet.
Energy drinks are very sweet.
It's actually more common to say energiedrankjes, so to use the diminutive form, or even just energy drink. I've never really liked those, to be honest. They smell like cat pee and they have like 30 sugar cubes in them, so don't do drugs, kids.
Verwerkt vlees.
Verwerkt vlees.
Processed meat.
Next one. Verwerkt vlees.
Processed meat.
Ik vind verwerkt vlees niet lekker.
Ik vind verwerkt vlees niet lekker.
I don't like processed meat. Does processed meat kill you faster than unprocessed meat does? I'm not really sure why that would be, but if you do know, tell me in the comments because I'm actually very curious now.
Diepvriesmaaltijd. Diepvriesmaaltijd. Frozen meal.
Next word. Diepvriesmaaltijd.
Frozen meals.
Mijn broer eet veel diepvriesmaaltijden.
Mijn broer eet veel diepvriesmaaltijden.
My brother eats a lot of frozen meals. Yeah, that would be unhealthy, especially if he still eats them while they're frozen. So that's no wonder he's going to die young. Sorry.
Chips.
Chips. Potato chips. Next word. Chips.
Chips.
Potato chips. Tijdens de film eet ik graag chips.
Tijdens de film eet ik graag chips.
I like to eat potato chips during a movie. Ah, salt and fat, how I love you. So what's your favorite flavor in chips? Or crisps, should I probably say. I really like the vinegar and sea salt ones. So anyway, notice that the Dutch word for fries is patat. So we actually use the word chips just for potato chips.
Margarine.
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 Wij gebruiken thuis boter in plaats van margarine.
Wij gebruiken thuis boter in plaats van margarine.
At home, we use butter instead of margarine. Does margarine kill you? I don't know, guys. I think butter is just as bad. Maybe olive oil is still okay?
Magnetron popcorn. Magnetron popcorn.
Microwave popcorn. Ah, the next one. I love this next one.
Magnetron popcorn.
Microwave popcorn.
Magnetron popcorn is erg slecht.
Magnetron popcorn is erg slecht. Microwave popcorn is very bad. I actually think popcorn in general isn't very good for you, but I suppose that does include microwave popcorn. Anyway, don't let it get you down. Popcorn is delicious, and if anything about popcorn kills me, it'll be one of those little skins that get between your teeth, and I'll die of an infection.
Instant noodles.
Instant noodles.
Instant noodles.
Instant noodles.
Instant noodles.
Op werk eet ik elke dag instant noodles.
Op werk eet ik elke dag instant noodles.
Every day at work, I eat instant noodles. I bet you didn't see that one coming. Look, do what you have to do. Just drink some water afterward because the salt content in those cups is not okay.
Snoep.
Snoep.
Candy.
Ah,
This next one just, this is what's going to kill me, definitely. Snoep. Candy. Wat is je favoriete snoep? Wat is je favoriete snoep? What is your favorite candy? Frisdrank. Frisdrank. Soda. Next one is frisdrank. Soda. Frisdrank is slecht voor je tanden. Frisdrank is slecht voor je tanden. Soda is bad for your teeth. This is a really depressing lesson, guys. How about we talk about some of the good things of
how to talk about saving the planet in Dutch? April 22nd is Earth Day, so let's talk about what you and I can do to help preserve the planet. Recyclen. Recyclen. To recycle. Recyclen is goed voor het milieu. Recyclen is goed voor het milieu. Recycling is good for the environment. As you can see, this Dutch word comes from the English word to recycle, but because Dutch verbs always end on en, you need to stick that at the end to get recyclen. Vrijwilliger. Vrijwilliger. Volunteer. Mijn vader is een vrijwilliger. Mijn vader is een vrijwilliger. My dad is a volunteer. So this word consists of two important parts, which are vrij, which means free, and wil, which means will. So this word means that you're doing it of your own free will, so no compensation. Next word, beschermen. Beschermen. To protect. We moeten de aarde beschermen. We moeten de aarde beschermen. We must protect the earth. I think most people will agree with me on this one, so hopefully you won't need to repeat this too often. By the way, the word beschermen has scherm in it, which means shield or screen. Next word is hergebruiken. Hergebruiken, which means to reuse. Ik hergebruik veel videobanden. Ik hergebruik veel videobanden. I reuse a lot of videotapes. To be honest, this sample sentence is a bit useless, because most of you probably have never even seen a videotape. You know those big clunky black bricks before DVDs? Well, those hold exactly one film. Next is bewaren. Bewaren. To conserve. Wij bewaren veel oude kranten. Wij bewaren veel oude kranten. We conserve a lot of old newspapers. Now, what you eventually do with those newspapers is probably more important than the fact you're just stacking them up in your basement. Personally, I use my old newspapers to line my birdcage with. Afval verminderen. Afval verminderen. To reduce trash. Probeer thuis het afval te verminderen. Probeer thuis het afval te verminderen. Try to reduce trash at home. By this, I think they mean that you should try to produce as little trash as possible. So bring your own bags to the store and use as little plastics as you can. Geven om het milieu. Geven om het milieu. To care for the environment. Haar stichting geeft om het milieu. Haar stichting geeft om het milieu. Her foundation cares for the environment. So the Dutch words geven om literally mean give for, but they mean that you care about something and usually also that you're making an effort. Gebruik van milieuvriendelijke producten. Gebruik van milieuvriendelijke producten. To use eco-friendly products. Mijn opa maakt gebruik van milieuvriendelijke producten. Mijn opa maakt gebruik van milieuvriendelijke producten. My grandfather uses a lot of eco-friendly products. I also try to use eco-friendly products whenever I can around the home. You know, dishwashing and washing my clothes and stuff. If you guys have any tips on what other eco-friendly products are useful, you can let me know in the comments because I'm always on the lookout. Next up, spaarlamp. Spaarlamp. Low energy light bulb. Ik gebruik alleen maar spaarlampen. Ik gebruik alleen maar spaarlampen. I only use low energy light bulbs. So this is a nice way to reduce your impact on the environment, but I really dislike the look of those ugly pale light bulbs. So these days the regular light bulbs aren't even sold in the Netherlands anymore, so that really makes the decision easier. Zonnepanelen. Zonnepanelen. Solar panels. Op het dak liggen 10 zonnepanelen. Op het dak liggen 10 zonnepanelen. There are 10 solar panels on the roof. Do you guys have solar panels? We do, but they've been there since autumn, so we haven't gotten a lot of real energy from them yet. Anyway, the sun's been coming out more and more, so who knows?
Want to speed up your language learning? Get access to all of our best PDF cheat sheets for free. Just click the link in the description and sign up for your free lifetime account right now. In this video, you'll learn 3 reasons you're never too old to learn a language, and you'll also learn 3 ways our learning system can help people of all ages to study efficiently. Number 1, seniors have better focus. Learning a new language in your 50s or 60s may actually be easier than learning as a teenager or young adult. More mature adults can better focus on the details necessary to master a new language. Older people are also often more dedicated to their goals and put more work into achieving them. Seniors are better able to focus on completing lessons and reaching goals. There are a lot of distractions out there these days for young people. There's everything from Facebook to Instagram and all the usual drama of daily life at work and at school. Seniors are typically less concerned with these kinds of things and are better at focusing on tasks until completion. This is extremely important for language study, where regular practice and attention to detail are key. Not only are you never too old to learn, you may have some advantages over younger learners. Our language learning program has a number of special tools to make learning a new language in your 50s or 60s easy. You'll use the same resources as a tech-savvy teenager. Number 2, learning is vital to healthy and happy living. Learning is actually vital to your health. Doing things like playing word games, doing puzzles, and even using online platforms like Luminosity do help keep the mind nimble. But nothing compares to learning a second language in terms of health benefits for your mind. Learning another language may be one of the very best retirement hobbies you can pick up. You can also apply your second language knowledge when you travel. Number 3, there are health benefits to learning new things after the age of 60. Learning a second language increases the number of neural pathways in the brain. Forging these new neural pathways helps you code and sort the new language you are learning. In addition, there are other brain health benefits associated with learning a new language. Here's a list of benefits bilingual people can enjoy. Higher overall general intelligence, better memory and memorization skills, better perception of surroundings, better focus, concentration, and attention to detail. So in a very real way, learning a new language is one of the best and most practical retirement hobbies you can find because it helps protect against cognitive decline as you age. Now let's talk about how our language learning program has methods to make sure you can start learning in your 50s, 60s, and beyond. Number 1, we have an intuitive, easy-to-use system. Learning in old age doesn't have to be hard or irritating. It can and should be fun. From your very first lesson, we'll make sure you're speaking fluently, every day. You can start and stop each lesson as many times as you want. Study when you want, where you want, and at the pace you decide. Number 2, you'll find special tools to boost retention and performance. As we mature, learning to use the right tools is vital to getting jobs done fast and right. So we make it easier than ever to make learning in old age fun and rewarding with a wide range of tools to boost retention and performance, including spaced repetition flashcards, so you can learn vocab fast, line-by-line audio transcripts, so you can read along with each lesson, pronunciation and accent review, instructor lesson notes, review quizzes, 2,000 core words, enough for fluency. You are truly never too old to learn, with more than 20 tools and resources to help boost learning and performance. Number 3, you'll get support every step of the way. Although you may never be too old to learn, it doesn't hurt to have a little help along the way. Our language learning system has helped thousands of seniors learn and master a new language with help and support at every step. We offer 24/7 assistance. Just send us an email. We have dedicated language experts standing by to help you with any problem or issue you may be experiencing. There is also instructor feedback. Have specific questions about a lesson or your progress? You can directly email instructors and get direct responses to any question you may have about your studies or lessons. Or try studying with your very own instructor. Members of our exclusive Premium Plus plan not only get a custom curriculum tailored to their very own goals, they also gain access to their very own language instructor. Learning in old age isn't just a luxury. It's crucial to helping avoid the onset of Alzheimer's, dementia, and other age-related cognitive issues. Specifically, learning another language helps increase overall intelligence and improve awareness, memory, and overall cognitive function. So, not only are you never too old to learn a new language for health reasons, it's a great way to meet new people and start adventures. Want to cut your language studying time in half? In this video, you'll discover how learning a language using PDF lessons is convenient, efficient, and can help you cut your studying time nearly in half. Many people give up on their dream of learning a second language because traditional classroom instruction is too much of a hassle. Between getting to class, studying on someone else's schedule, and just the sheer expense of the books and tuition, traditional learning can be tough. Many people simply give up. Online classes are an option, but sometimes limited data plans can derail the dream of learning a new language. Fortunately, there is a solution: learning language using PDF lesson notes. Let's take a closer look at how studying language lessons in PDF format can help you reach your dream in about half the time of normal video or audio lessons. First, print all lessons and PDF tools and take them with you anywhere. Sometimes a tiny smartphone screen just isn't adequate, especially when you're trying to learn something new. The great thing about PDF lessons is that they can be quickly printed and taken anywhere after you download them. In fact, printing out lessons in PDF format can actually save you time when compared to going through the material on a smartphone with a small screen, even with the extra printing time. Second, they're a great study tool to boost retention and mastery. Studying video or audio lessons online is a great way to learn a language because students can play and rewind sections as many times as needed until the lesson is mastered. But when you review the same lessons again in PDF format, an incredible thing happens. Your retention dramatically improves. Thanks to time-spaced repetition, seeing the information again in written format helps reinforce the information in your mind and improves both retention and recall. The benefits of learning a language using PDF lessons quickly add up to significant time savings for you, your data plan, and your dream of learning a new language. Third, all lessons in PDF format include in-depth instructor notes. We have thousands of HD video and audio lessons, and each one includes a PDF version with a line-by-line transcript so you can read along with the lesson as it appears online. In addition to the line-by-line transcript, all lessons include in-depth instructor notes with more information, sample sentences, explanations, and translations. The additional information and notes help you learn faster and with greater mastery than using the video or audio lessons alone. And when paired with language learning video games, video and audio lessons, or other study aids, our PDF lessons help you reach your dream of learning a new language faster and easier than many traditional classroom settings. Fourth, you can download the world's largest online collection of lessons by real instructors. Planning on going on vacation and don't know if you'll have reliable internet service? If you're learning through PDF lessons, it's not a problem. Once you download lessons in PDF format to your smartphone, PC, or favorite media device, they are yours to use and keep forever. Once downloaded, you can either print out or access your lessons in PDF format, regardless of internet access. When you consistently learn through PDF lessons, the time savings and benefits quickly compound. From quicker access to faster learning, PDF lessons can potentially reduce total study time required to learn a concept. Our PDF lessons include instructor notes and supplemental resources that help you learn faster and with less effort. Does having a study partner help you learn a language faster? For most people, having a friend or romantic partner who is a native speaker of their target language dramatically improves their ability to master the language. In this video, we'll talk about some ways to help you build relationships with people. We'll also talk about three reasons having a native speaker partner can improve your language fluency. First, knowing a native speaker helps you better understand the culture. Knowing a native speaker gets you connected with the culture in ways that no lessons or textbooks ever could. Native speakers are better informed about the latest slang expressions and know interesting places to eat and hang out. Having a friend or partner who is a native speaker can dramatically improve your understanding of the language. In addition to language, you can learn about cultural practices, gestures, and relationships. Second, having a native speaker partner increases your exposure to the language. Practice makes perfect is a well-known expression that is certainly true for language learning. When you have a friend, romantic partner, or study buddy, you speak to them through text messages, phone calls, and basic interaction. These are all opportunities for you to practice the language. Making an effort to practice will help your vocabulary quickly expand beyond simple greetings, flirtatious words, and basic comments to deeper, more meaningful conversations. Third, a supportive partner is the best study aid you can find. We all make mistakes, especially when trying to learn a new language. But if you have a supportive partner, they can gently point out your mistakes and help you find better ways to express yourself. And if your native speaker study partner is also your romantic partner, your motivation will likely be even higher than someone who does not have a romantic relationship with a native speaker. Now, let's look at three ways our language learning program helps you learn even faster if you have a native speaker partner. First, all resources and materials are available in English and in your target language. Studying with a partner is special because it's an opportunity for both of you to learn a new language. That's why every single lesson, transcript, vocabulary list, and resource on our website is available in English and in your target language. You can learn from each other. Second, lessons are designed to help you understand and engage with culture. On our website, our focus is to help our students learn practical vocabulary and phrases that are actually used in everyday conversation. This means that from your very first lesson, you can start applying what you learn immediately. So if you want to go out to a restaurant, play games, or attend a social function with your partner, you'll have the vocabulary and phrases necessary to have a great time. Third, access to special resources dedicated to romantic phrases. If your study partner is your romantic partner, we have resources to help you communicate your feelings correctly. Our language learning program has special sections and tools to teach you love words, phrases, and cultural insights. Of course, please remember that simply being in a relationship is no substitute for studying. Communication is key to every relationship, whether romantic or not. If you fail to continue expanding your vocabulary and you stop learning the language on your own, your relationships may suffer or fizzle out. Without question, spending time with native speakers can help you dramatically improve your language proficiency. But this is no replacement for focused studying. It's essential to help facilitate better communication and master the language. Want to transform your driving time into language learning time? How much time do you spend in your car every day? 30 minutes? More than an hour? Why not put this huge amount of time to good use? Instead of just listening to the radio during your daily commute, you could be learning a new language instead. Here are three easy methods for learning a language in your car. You can put them to use right away with the help of our language learning program. First, you can listen to fun audio lessons by real teachers. Listening to lessons while in the car allows you to focus on the road as you listen and learn. In every one of our 3 to 15 minute lessons, our teachers teach you conversations, new phrases, and cultural points. Audio is the only learning medium that lets you learn and drive safely at the same time, so take advantage of all our audio lessons available. Second, you can set your lessons on autoplay and go hands-free. Our autoplay feature lets you keep your hands on the wheel without even reaching for your device. Just set your lessons to autoplay one by one with our innovative Language 101 app and never have to interrupt your focus on driving to switch to a new lesson. Third, you can repeat out loud and speak from your very first lesson. You want to speak a new language too, right? Well, you'll start learning conversations minutes into your lessons. All you have to do is listen and repeat out loud. Our teachers take you step by step through all of the words, phrases, translations, and grammar points. You're even prompted to speak out loud and repeat. The result? You understand it all and can speak your new language. Turn your commute into language learning time and have fun at the same time. Learning doesn't have to be a big commitment, like signing up for a college class. It can be fun and easy. In fact, it's as easy as pressing play. Our language learning programs will do the work for you. And with the exposure you get while driving on your daily commute, you'll be speaking and understanding real-life language quickly. The best part? You can finally learn without even changing your schedule. So if you're ready to finally learn a new language the fast, fun, and easy way, sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Signing up takes less than 30 seconds, and you'll start speaking from your very first lesson. If you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye! The three powerful language learning lessons you'll pick up at the gym. And today, you're going to learn 1. How to approach your goals, 2. How to find time to learn a language, and 3. Why you don't need the best possible routine or learning program. So, if you've ever spent time in the gym, you'll quickly see how similar training and language learning are. But before we move on, listen up. Here are this month's new lessons and resources. First, want to perfect your pronunciation? Then get our new pronunciation PDF cheat sheet right now. You'll learn how to sound like a native speaker and how to practice your pronunciation. Second, do you know the 7 tested ways to learn language fast? With this new ebook, you'll learn how to use our learning system to speak better, remember more words, and improve fast. Download it for free right now. Third, 20 useful phrases for a hair salon. Would you be able to get a haircut in your target language? If you said no, then this 1-minute lesson is just what you need. Fourth, 20 phrases for doing business successfully. If you're learning the language for work, this 1-minute lesson is for you. You'll learn the 20 most common greetings, phrases, and questions for business meetings. To get your free resources, click the link in the description below right now. They're yours to keep forever. Okay, let's jump into today's topic. The three powerful language learning lessons you'll pick up at the gym. The first lesson is how to approach your goals and language learning. So, why are we talking about the gym? The gym is a great example because it's filled with people working on their goals, and it gives you a snapshot of where most people are with their goals. And everyone there has one goal, to be fit. But not everyone is there yet. You have a few people that look like fitness models. Then you have around 20 or 30 people that have good, respectable physiques, the middle group. And then the rest of the people are still working their way up. It's motivating because everyone has a chance of succeeding. If you've been to the gym, you understand the importance of repetition, doing reps. A rep is the number of times you do a certain exercise. Like 15 push-ups is 15 reps of push-ups. So even people still working toward their goals have a chance of succeeding if they put in the reps. If they do a little bit a day over a long period of time, they'll get there. The process is simple. The more you do, the longer you stick with it, the more progress you make. And the same goes for learning language or any other goal in life. It's about putting in the reps a little bit a day, consistently, for a long period of time. If you want to get bigger muscles, you pick up a dumbbell and you do reps. If you want to learn more words, you do the reps. 5 new words a day. So, what can you do right now? For example, if you're using our program, just do 1 lesson a day. If you have a textbook, do 1 page a day. If you're using an app, put in 5 minutes a day. Again, everyone has a chance to succeed. They just need to put in the reps, and they need to make the time. This is where the second lesson comes in. You'll learn how to find and make time to learn a language. There's a reason the people you see at the gym daily, and especially the people you see at 10 p.m. on a Friday, are the ones with above average results. They're the most consistent. But how do they get that level of consistency? There tend to be 3 types of people. First, the people that have plenty of free time, so it's a non-issue for them. Second, the busier people. They make time regardless of what their schedule is like, meaning they show up at 1 a.m. just to fit in a session, or they cancel other plans to make time. And third, the people who have made it a habit. They're so used to going that they don't have to think about it. Ideally, you want to be in the third group with language learning. But most people fall into the second group. The truth is that to make time, they have to cancel other plans. Some wake up earlier to squeeze in a session in the AM. Some go late at night. It's the same exact thing with language learning. You make time. The good news with language learning is you don't need to open up a lesson at 1 a.m. and put in an hour. With our learning program, you'll get our quick but powerful 3 to 15 minute audio and video lessons. And because the lessons are short, you can easily make time. You can do a lesson on your commute or while walking somewhere. Imagine learning a quick conversation while on your way to the store. Finally, the third language learning lesson you'll learn at the gym is why you don't need the best possible routine to get results. Have you ever heard a friend say, "I have to start the right way. It has to be perfect." Well, this is a disastrous way to start anything, whether fitness or language learning. And most learners spend a lot of time worrying about starting right, instead of just starting and keeping at it. But the point is, if you start learning from a textbook and stick with it, you'll get results. You'll improve your reading, vocabulary, and grammar. Of course, it won't get you speaking. You'll only get good at what you focus on. But the fact is, you'll still make progress. Same with the gym. If you start off with bicep curls, you'll see progress in time. But at some point, you'll need to add in legs as well. You can't skip leg day. So here's what you can learn. Here's what smart beginners do. They don't look for the best way to start. They just start and keep going. And once they have a consistent routine, they start optimizing. They improve their routine. If you start taking one lesson a day and can easily maintain that routine, then you might eventually realize that you want to practice speaking. You need to shadow that lesson's conversation. So you add shadowing to your routine, and that's how you grow. Same thing with the gym. The smart beginners make sure they do their reps and come in as much as possible. And doing the basics is enough for them to build muscle. Later on, they'll start adjusting their exercises and adding new ones. But you'll never get to that point if you overthink yourself into inaction and don't build that habit. So as long as you start and continue, most starting routines and learning methods are good enough. You don't need the best possible one right now. You could have the best possible language learning program, but if you don't use it consistently, it's useless. All right, so today you learned 1, how to approach your goals, 2, how to find time to learn a language, and 3, why you don't need the best possible routine or learning program. Hey everyone, welcome to the Monthly Review, the monthly show on language learning, where you discover new learning strategies, motivational tips, study tools, and resources. By the way, all the free lessons and bonuses you're about to see can be downloaded on our website. So click the link in the description right now to sign up for your free lifetime account. Okay, today's topic is how to speak more of your target language, talking points for language learners. And today you're going to learn 1, what talking points are, 2, 5 talking points you can use to start conversations and maximize your speaking time, and 3, how to get our conversation cheat sheets so you can speak even more of your target language. And you'll find out how to get them for free. If you've always wanted to speak more in your target language, then this episode is for you. I'll get into this in just a bit. If you're like most language learners, then your number one goal is to speak more, right? You want to have fluent conversations with natives. It's a great goal to have. But for most language learners, speaking also happens to be their weakest skill. You may not know enough of the language to express yourself. You tend to run out of words and things to say. And you're just not sure how to start conversation. If you have at least one of these issues, then talking points are just what you need. Part 1, what's a talking point? A talking point is a topic that invites discussion or argument. In other words, just something to talk about. It could be about yourself, your work, your hobbies, the weather, food, or what you did this past weekend. All of these are talking points. Here's an example to help you better understand talking points. Think of a conversation you'd have with a friend. You can ask, "What did you do this weekend?" They'll reply and then ask you back. The talking point here is the weekend. Let's say your friend says they went to a restaurant. That's a natural talking point to explore next. You can ask, "What kind of restaurants do you like?" Now you've covered 2 talking points. The more talking points you have, the more you can speak. And the same goes for your target language. The only challenge is you need to know the relevant words and phrases for that topic. For example, if you want to talk about the weekend, you need to know phrases and questions like, "What did you do this weekend?" "I did this." "What about you?" In the next part, you'll discover 5 easy talking points that you can master with our learning program. Let's get into part 2. Part 2, 5 talking points you can use. The first one is, learn how to introduce yourself in your target language. Why is this a powerful talking point? Introducing yourself is something you'll do again and again, every time you meet someone new. So learning the relevant phrases is a must. If you've done the first few lessons on our site, you can already do this. If not, then check out our Absolute Beginner lessons and the Top 25 Questions You Must Know lessons. You'll learn basic conversations with our quick 3 to 15 minute lessons. We'll give you the exact lines to use, along with the translations, so that you can use them in conversations. You can also use this talking point to continue a conversation. For example, if you've started with a different point, like the weather, then it makes sense to say, by the way, my name is. Talking point number 2, the weather. This is a universal talking point. People like to talk or complain about the weather all over the world. In fact, just saying, it's really nice today, is enough to start a conversation with a native speaker. If you want to talk about the weather, check out our Can-Do lesson pathway called Can Talk About Weather. You'll find this pathway in the absolute beginner level of our lesson library. Talking point number 3, compliments. Compliments are another great way to start a conversation or continue one. If you're running out of things to say, you can quickly transition and say something about their city, their country, or just, hey, I like your shirt. If you want to learn how to compliment, check out our compliments phrase list. This list is free to access for all users. If you don't know where to find it on our site, leave a comment in the comments below and we'll follow up. Point number 4, ask for help. For example, you can ask for directions or about the price and let the conversation go from there. These are very basic phrases that you learn in our survival phrases lessons. If you want to strike up a quick dialogue, this is a great talking point to use. Point number 5, learn phrases for transactions, like getting a room at a hotel, shopping, ordering food, or telling the taxi driver where to go. You may think that this isn't much of a talking point, but for the learners that are shy about talking to random native speakers for no reason, this is an easy way to start a dialogue. You have a good excuse. You want to buy something, so the staff will be happy to respond. Again, you learn all of these with our survival phrases lessons. Okay, let's move on to our last part. Part 3, how to get our conversation cheat sheets. Lastly, I'm going to tell you how to get our collection of conversation cheat sheets for free. With these cheat sheets, you'll be able to talk about all kinds of topics: travel, hobbies, dating, family, weather, and much more. Which means you can master a lot of talking points and speak more of your target language. If you'd like to get these cheat sheets, please leave us a comment in the comment section. So thank you for watching this episode of Monthly Review. Next time, we'll talk about how to double your speaking time in your target language. If you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. And if you're ready to finally learn language the fast, fun, and easy way, and start speaking from your very first lesson, get our complete learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account right now. Click the link in the description. See you next time. Bye! Great work. Here's a reward. Speed up your language learning with our PDF lessons. Get all of our best PDF cheat sheets and ebooks for free. Just click the link in the description.